If f of x equals the quantity 3x plus 1 divided by the quantity x minus 2, we want to find f prime of x, the derivative function, and f prime of 1. Because our function is a quotient, we'll have to apply the quotient rule in order to find our derivative function. The quotient rule is stated here, where if we want to find the derivative of a quotient function, where the numerator is function f and the denominator is function g, the derivative is equal to g times f prime minus f times g prime divided by g squared. So we have the denominator times the derivative of the numerator minus the numerator times the derivative of the denominator all divided by the denominator squared. So as you can see, the quotient rule is fairly involved. One way to help remember the quotient rule is given here in blue, where if big D represents the derivative, high represents the function in the numerator, and low represents the function in the denominator, we can state the quotient rule as low d high minus high d low, low low. Once again, we have low d high minus high d low, low low. So if you were to say this or even sing it about 10 times, you would probably remember the quotient rule, where again we have the denominator or the low function times the derivative of the high function of the numerator minus the high function or the numerator times the derivative of the low function, all divided by low low, which is the denominator squared. So looking at our given function, if f of x equals the quantity 3x plus 1 divided by the quantity x minus 2, using the formal quotient rule, we let the numerator be equal to f and the denominator be equal to g, or if we want to use high and low instead, the numerator would be high and the denominator would be low. So whichever formula we want to use, f prime of x is going to be equal to the function where the denominator is just the denominator squared, so we'd have the quantity x minus 2 squared. Then the numerator is going to be the denominator times the derivative of the numerator minus the numerator times the derivative of the denominator. So again, we can look at this as g times f prime minus f times g prime divided by g squared, or low d high minus high d low, low low. So notice how for this first step, we wrote out the quotient rule but didn't find any derivatives. So now we'll go back and find the derivative here, here, and begin to simplify. So f prime of x is equal to, the denominator is going to stay the same, and then we'll have the quantity x minus 2 times the derivative of 3x plus 1. The derivative of 3x would just be 3, the derivative of 1 is 0, minus the quantity 3x plus 1 times the derivative of x minus 2. The derivative of x is 1. The derivative of negative 2 is 0, so we just have 1. Now we'll go and distribute and combine like terms. So we have f prime of x is equal to, again, the denominator stays the same. If we distribute here, we would have 3x minus 6. We need to be careful here because we're subtracting this product. Here we're just distributing 1, which isn't going to change anything. We have minus the quantity 3x plus 1, which would be minus 3x minus 1. Notice how the x terms are opposites. 3x minus 3x is 0. So our derivative function, f prime of x, is going to be negative 7 divided by the quantity x minus 2 squared. Now the second part of this question asks us to find f prime of 1. So now that we have our derivative function, we'll substitute 1 for x and evaluate the derivative function. Remember, this will tell us the slope of the tangent line when x equals 1. Let's go ahead and do this on the next slide. So f prime of 1 is going to be equal to negative 7 divided by the quantity 1 minus 2 squared. So negative 7, this will be negative 1 squared. So f prime of 1 is equal to negative 7. Let's go ahead and verify this by looking at the graph of our function. So here's the graph of our function. Notice when x equals 1, we'd be at this point here on the function. And since we found f prime of 1 equals negative 7, if we sketch a tangent line at this point, it would look something like this. It's a little hard to tell, but it does look like the slope of this tangent line would be equal to negative 7. Notice how the y-axis is scaled by 4s. Okay, I hope you found this introductory video on the quotient rule helpful.